It's getting late. Nobody's gonna swipe right in me anyways. I should probably clean up the mess downstairs before I crash for the night.
Feeling all right, Klopchik?
Who's a good boy? Who's a good boy? Just you want a good boy. Just you want.
I don't need to worry about it right now. I should finish cleaning before I go back upstairs. Believe some old lady I never met just left me this house. Talk about winning the lottery. I didn't even know I was playing. No girl is gonna date me with a house this messy. Jesus, I made a damn mess. I should finish cleaning before I go back upstairs.
Shit!
Jesus! Paul! Oh, I need to turn the volume down. I'm gonna get a noise complaint. Would you look at that? I guess someone liked what they saw. Online dating is so overrated. I guess there's no time like the present. Maybe the keys to those rooms are in the boxes of her stuff in the attic. This is for that old clock downstairs. Fixed. And nothing happened. Did I miss something? What's this? I don't need to worry about it right now. I've got to tell Martha about this. No. There's no way this is real. This is... Jesus. Huh? Bet this unlocks that desk in the attic.
no way this is real. This is the day she died. I've got to tell Martha about this. Am I really sitting here playing with kids' toys? What now? What the hell tripped this? I'm not using that much power.
That was fast. Okay, somebody is definitely fucking with me. Might as well stay busy, though. Not like I'm gonna get any sleep now.
Thank you.
so are you going to explain what the hell's going on?
Look, I appreciate being able to crash on your couch last night, but...
Look, I get that this is all really weird, but there are a few things you need to understand. And I promise that it'll all make sense. Or at least it will if you keep an open mind.
So crazy.
Well, I guess the first thing you should know is that this is so hard to say.
Well, spit it out then.
Okay, okay. Look, I knew you were going to move into that house. I've kind of been waiting for you for a few years now. I wasn't stalking you. I've been trying to keep an eye on you. You know, so that you were safe. I knew you'd be moving in yesterday because, well, I know some things about your grandmother. Your whole family, actually.
That's some pretty stuff to lay on someone you just met last night.
I know, but just listen. Have you ever wondered why you were adopted? I mean, like, what actually happened to your mom? Or why your dad didn't take you in?
Not really. I was told that my mom died during childbirth and there's no other family.
That was a lie. You did have a family. You had a brother and a sister. And your mom didn't die during childbirth. She was murdered. And she was pregnant with you when it happened.
Yeah, okay, Marty. It's not like anyone would have told me if it was true. Even if it is, I'm sure the records would have been buried. Well, how did you find this out?
I was adopted too.
Huh?
After the incident, I was injured pretty bad. A shotgun blast at close range will do that. The doctor said that my amnesia was a result of the trauma. And it took most of my life to recover my memory of what happened.
Are you saying what I think you're saying?
About 5 years ago, I started to remember things and started searching for answers about what happened. That's when I found out you were alive. That you survived too.
No fucking way. This is impossible.
Daniel, I know it's a lot, but I'm your sister.
No. I can't believe that.
Well, it's true. I was there.
Wow. For being honest, I honestly did wonder. In that other life, didn't think I'd find out I was part of something crazy like this.
Yeah, it's crazy. Unless you know what good old grandma was up to. Best I can piece it together, she was someone pretty high up in a secret society. And whatever cult she was a part of had her brainwash our father into doing it.
That doesn't make any sense. What purpose could she or they possibly have had to mind control some guy into killing his family?
Well, what little I found out about the cult says that they needed a child to be born from extreme trauma. An act of violence that could force its birth so that the child could act as a vessel for... Well, I really don't know. A vessel for something not good. And that child would have to attain maturity before being of use to them.
You mean?
Yeah, you know what today is.
My fucking...
Bingo! Why do you think you were finally able to move into Grandma's house yesterday? the very day before your 18th birthday? Because they planned on doing whatever they intended as soon as you were of age.
So how did you stay off Grandpa's radar? I mean, you live next door. How did she not know?
I moved into that house 2 years ago. By then, I knew there was no way she'd recognize me. You weren't born yet, but the last time she came to visit, I was only a year old. So when I got the house next to hers, I just kept my head down and avoided her as much as I could, while keeping an eye on everything.
Oh man, this is all too much. So now we're going where? And why are we going to wherever it is that we're going?
I was able to track down where our family was supposedly buried. And, well, there's something I need to see for myself before I know what to do next.
Yeah? What's that?
I need to know if our dad is buried there too.
Fuck.
We're getting close, and I'll get my answers. And yours, real soon. I know this is a lot. Are you okay?
I always figured something would happen and my real family would come find me. I just didn't expect it to be, you know.
Daniel, look out!
Holy shit. Oh, that was way too close.
Well, we aren't far from where we need to go. Looks like there's a trail over there that we can take to where the gravesite is.
Alright. Guess we walk from here.
Yeah, it shouldn't be a bad hike. But you go on ahead. I need to grab my bag from the trunk and handle a little something. I'll join you when I'm done.
What? No, we should stick together.
Go on, you big baby. I was going to send you on ahead this whole time. I just need to do this one thing really quick. Alone.
Fine. Whatever. Just be careful. Call me if you need a hand, I guess.
Thanks, but I'll be okay. I promise it won't take long. It'll be worth it. Oh, and one more thing.
Shit, Martha, a gun? Really?
When I first found out about you, I started looking further into the society that Grandma belonged to. I wasn't able to dig up much, but I did find out about a gathering they were having. I managed to find a place to hide and watch, and during the meeting, well, I stole this. It's some kind of relic for them.
Seriously? A relic? It's just a fucking handgun.
I know it looks like it's nothing special, but the way they were handling it, it was like they were touching Excalibur or something. I want you to take it, just to be safe. I already took it to a gun range and tested it. It works just like a normal gun.
You're joking, right? I've never even held a gun before.
Just take it. I'll feel better knowing you've got something to defend yourself in case those nut jobs come looking for you.
I swear, I just saw something huge. I don't think I'm alone in here.
Are you hurt?
No. I'm just freaked out.
I get it. It is spooky out here. Surprised we haven't run into anybody else. But hey, wasn't I supposed to be the one calling you?
I mean, you're right.
I'm sure I'll still get to play the damsel in distress at some point. But seriously, call me if anything happens.
I will. Oh, and thanks for letting me keep Plopsick at your place while we do all this. I can't bear the thought of leaving him in that spook fest of a house. I feel so bad moving in there now. Poor little guy.
No sweat. As long as he doesn't chew up the furniture, we're all good.
No promises on that. don't need to worry about it right now.
Alive, if that's what you mean by okay. I just got attacked by a weird figure-faced dog monster.
A fucking what?
No, I don't know. I can't explain it, but there's something else out of here too. It's like the whole world is descending at the freaking moon, and we've got front row seat tickets.
Try to avoid any more encounters if you can.
Man, I really didn't dress right to go on a hike today.
So I went the wrong way. This is over. I'm gonna sleep for a week. I just came across a river. I'm not really sure which way to go from here.
You're getting closer. Keep the water on your left side, and you'll be there in no time.
Thanks. Hey, I know it's kind of out of the blue, but how much do you remember about our mom and dad? I guess all this walking got me thinking about stuff.
Well, my memory of them is still kind of sketchy. I remember Mom baking the most amazing chocolate chip cookies. She was always so loving. She took really good care of Michael and me.
Michael? That was my brother?
Yeah. He was great. Never picked on me or anything.
What about Dad?
He always seemed distracted. He seemed so happy at first, but then he was kind of a drag. He'd sit in front of the TV for hours when he came home, watching the same shows over and over. Over and over. He wouldn't shower or even change his clothes for days on end. Then the drinking started. He never lashed out at us, but he just wasn't the same anymore.
I'm sorry, Marty. I shouldn't have asked.
No, it's okay. You deserve to know. They were your parents, too.
Thanks, Marty. Thank you.
This is insane. Where the hell did this thing come from?
Martha, how much longer are you going to keep me waiting in this dump?
Just a sec.
Look, I really appreciate that you're going through all this trouble for my birthday, but I'm seriously bored just standing around out here.
Relax, it's almost ready.
I swear that you've got me out here just to pull a dump, right?
Dude, chill out, man. Just call me when you find the graveyard.
Okay, I'll keep looking around. Yeah, I'm not gonna risk melting my face off. Maybe there's a way to turn this off? I gotta figure out some way to open this. I don't need to worry about it right now. I don't need to worry about it right now.